टुडे लेक्चर इज डिकम्पोजिशन ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक मैटर. नो व्हाट इज ऑर्गेनिक मैटर. ऑर्गेनिक मैटर नॉन एज नेचुरल ऑर्गेनिक मैटर डिफाइंड एज लार्ज सोर्स ऑफ कार्बन बेस्ड कंपाउंड फाउंड विद इन नेचुरल इंजीनियर्ड टेरेस्ट्रियल एंड एक्वाटिक एनवायरमेंट. इट इज मैटर कंपोज ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड डेट हैव come from the remains of organisms such as plants, animals and their waste products in the environment. Organic molecule can also be made by chemical reaction that don't involve life. Basic structures are created from cellulose, tannin, cutin, lignin along with other various proteins, lipids, carbohydrates. Organic matter is very important in movement of nutrients in the environment and plays a role in water retention on the surface of planet. Not all organic compounds are created by living organisms, and living organisms do not leave behind organic material. Urea is one of many organic compounds that can be synthesized without any biological activity. Organic matter in terms of weight is 45-55% carbon, 35-45% oxygen, 3-5% hydrogen and 1-4% nitrogen. A majority of organic matter not already in soil comes from groundwater. When the groundwater saturates the soil or sediment around it, organic matter can freely move between the phases. Groundwater has its own source of natural organic matter. Organic matter deposits such as kerogen and coal, soil and sediment organic matter. Organic matter infiltrating into subsurface from rivers, lakes and marine system. One source of groundwater organic matter is soil organic matter and sedimentary organic matter. The major method of movement into soil is from groundwater, but organic matter from soil moves into groundwater as well. Most of the matter in lakes, rivers and surface water areas comes from deteriorated material in water and surrounding shores and some from groundwater. The movement enables a cycle to form. Organisms decompose into organic matter which is then transported and recycled. Not all biomass migrates, some is rather stationary, turning only over the course of millions of years. The type of organic matter in supplies are very diverse. It is largely decaying vegetable matter, but there are many other possible sources, including runoff from fields and domestic and industrial waste. Cycling of organic matter is important. As organic matter is common throughout the ecosystem, it is cycled through decomposition process by soil microbial communities that are crucial for nutrient availability. After degrading and reacting, it can move into soil and mainstream water via water flow. Organic matter provides nutrition to living organism. Organic matter acts as buffer in aqueous solution to maintain a neutral pH in the environment. The buffer acting component has been proposed to be relevant neutralizing the acid rain. Sources of organic matter. Biochemical oxygen demand is an indirect measure of biodegradable organic compound in water, and it is determined by measuring the dissolved oxygen decrease in controlled water supply sample over 5-day period. During this 5-day period, aerobic oxygen consuming bacteria decompose organic matter in sample and consume dissolved oxygen in proportion to the amount of organic material that is present. Nutrients are chemical elements or compounds essential for plant and animal growth. Nutrient parameters include ammonia, organic nitrogen, nitrate nitrogen and total phosphorus. higher amount of nutrients have been associated with eutrophication, as increased eutrophication means increased amounts of nutrient as nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium due to application of fertilizers, pesticide. While low level of nutrients can reduce plant growth and stress high level organism that consume phytoplankton, at least 16 essential chemical nutrients for plant growth to perform various physiological functions. Carbon, hydrogen, oxygen from air, nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, magnesium, calcium, iron, manganese, zinc, copper, boron, molybdenum and chlorine from soil. Organic carbon in water occurs as partially degraded plant and animal material, some of which are resistant to microbial degradation. Organic carbon is important in food web and is incorporated into the ecosystem by photosynthesis of green plants. Then this organic carbon consumed as carbohydrates and other organic compounds by higher animals. In another process, living tissue containing carbon is decomposed as detritus by bacteria and other microbes. Oil and grease constitute one of the most common parameters for quantifying organics from human source, and lesser extent biogenic sources means algae, fish. Some examples of oil and grease loadings are leaks from automobile, crankcases, illegal dumping into storm spills, motor boats, oil spills and discharge from oil production platform in the bay. Process of decomposition. For decomposition to take place, certain process occur: assimilation, uptake, or also it is a form of immobilization, conversion of substrate mineral into protoplasmic material as organic matter carbon content converted to microbial carbon, or protein conversion to microbial protein. Mineralization is a decomposition, or you can say it is oxidation of the chemical compounds in organic matter, by which nutrients in those compounds are released into soluble inorganic form that may be easily available to plants. Mineralization, basically it is the opposite of immobilization. Mineralization increases the bioavailability of nutrients that were in decomposing organic compounds because of their quantities nitrogen, phosphorus and sulfur. Whether the decomposition of organic compound will result in mineralization or immobilization is dependent on its concentration ratio to that of carbon in organic matter. When nitrogen mineralize or immobilize depends on the carbon nitrogen ratio of the decomposing organic matter. Carbon nitrogen ratio is very important. If carbon nitrogen ratio is greater than 30:1, immobilization mostly occur, and if carbon nitrogen ratio is 20:1, mineralization most likely to occur. At ratio 20:30:1, both process may occur in balance. A carbon dioxide is released during generation of energy in decomposition, a process named as catabolism. The carbon nitrogen ratio of organic matter decreases. Now the next is immobilization. Immobilization is the conversion of inorganic compounds to organic compounds by microorganism or plants, by which it is prevented from being accessible to plants. Immobilization is the opposite of mineralization. where the inorganic nutrients are taken up by soil microbes, making them available for plant uptake. Immobilization process is biological process controlled by bacteria that consume an inorganic nitrogen and for amino acids and biological macromolecules. Again, carbon nitrogen ratio, which mentioned, is very important. For example, incorporating materials high in carbon to nitrogen ratio, such as sawdust, in which carbon to nitrogen ratio is very high, shown in this table. It stimulates soil microbial activity and increase the demand for nitrogen, leading to immobilization. This is known as priming effect, which I will discuss in detail in the next slide. Next is factors controlling decomposition. Organic matter that contains a high nitrogen content usually is easier to decompose than organic matter of lower nitrogen content. What is the reason? Reason is that the organic matter of higher nitrogen content contains less fiber, but an equally important reason is that microorganism of decay need nitrogen to produce their cell biomass. An organic residue containing 3 or 4% nitrogen may decompose several times faster than one containing 0.5 to 1% nitrogen. Of course, ammonia or nitrate nitrogen dissolved in water can be used by microorganism to decompose organic matter of low nitrogen content. In aquaculture pond, organic matter usually is low in fiber content and high in nitrogen content. And if it is not, this usually is ammonia and nitrate nitrogen in the water. The process of microbial decomposition of organic matter is controlled by several factors, to include water temperature, moisture, pH, dissolved oxygen concentration, and chemical composition of organic matter itself. The ideal situation for accumulation of organic matter in water bodies is low water temperature and pH, and predominate of fibrous vegetation such as reed swamp plants that are of low nitrogen content. Microbial activity have optimum moisture. Low moisture level leads to desiccation, slow diffusion, and high moisture level leads to low availability of oxygen and no degradation of lignin takes place. Now the next is pH. Bacterial function best in the pH range of 7 to 8.5. When the pH is lower, decomposition by fungi is favored over that by bacteria, especially at pH less than 6. Fungi are not as efficient as bacteria in decomposing organic matter, because they convert more of the organic matter to their own biomass. Aquaculture ponds typically are limited to maintain a sediment pH above 7. There usually is plenty of dissolved oxygen in water column, and the organic matter entering ponds tend to be easily decomposable. Crop residue contain many complex carbon compounds originating from cell walls, cellulose, hemicellulose. Chains of carbon with each carbon atom linked to other carbon form the backbone of organic molecules. These carbon chains with varying amount of attached oxygen, hydrogen, nitrogen, sulfur, phosphorus are the basis of both simple sugars and amino acids, and more complicated molecules of long carbon chains or rings. Depending on their chemical structure, decomposition is rapid as for sugar and starches and proteins, and slow for cellulose, fats, waxes and resins, and very slow for lignin. During decomposition process, microorganisms convert carbon structure of fresh residue into transformed carbon products in soil. There are many different types of organic molecules in soil. Some are simple molecules that have been synthesized directly from plants or other living organisms. These simple chemicals such as sugar, amino acids and cellulose are consumed by many organisms. For this reason, they don't remain in soil for longer time. Other chemicals such as resins and waxes also come directly from plants but are more difficult for soil microorganisms to break down. Humus is the result of successive steps in decomposition of organic matter. Because of the complex structure of humic substances, humus cannot be used by many microorganisms as an energy source and remains in the soil for relatively long time. Humus or humified organic matter is the remaining part of organic matter that has been used and transformed by many different soil microorganisms. It is stable component formed by humic substances including humic acid, fluvic acid. It is most widely distributed organic carbon containing material in terrestrial and aquatic environments. Humus cannot decompose readily because of its intimate interaction with soil mineral phases. Humus consists of different substances as fluvic acid, the fraction of humus that is soluble in water under all pH conditions. Humic acid, the fraction of humus that is also soluble in water except for conditions more acid than pH 2. Color dark brown. Humin, the fraction of humus that is not soluble in water at any pH and that cannot be extracted with strong base such as sodium hydroxide. Commonly black in color. Humic substances having their ability to interact with metal ions, oxides, hydroxides, minerals, organic compounds including toxic pollutants to form water soluble and water insoluble complexes. Through the formation of these complexes, humic substances can dissolve, mobilize and transport metals and organics in soil, water or accumulate in certain soil horizons. Accumulation of such complexes can contribute to a reduction of toxicity, for example, reduction of aluminum in acidic soil, capture of pollutants as herbicides including atrazine in the cavities of humic substances. Some of these substances function as natural plant hormones as auxin and gibberellin and are capable of improving seed germination, root initiation, uptake of plant nutrients and serve as sources of nitrogen, phosphorus and sulfur. About 35-55% of non-living part of organic matter is humus. It is an important buffer reducing fluctuation in soil acidity and nutrient availability. There are many organisms that break down organic material. Most are not seen by human eye, but they are throughout the process. Others that are large enough to see are usually associated with later breakdown stages. The most important organism in breakdown process are bacteria. The bacteria present in any given pile are dependent on the raw material present, amount of air in the pile, moisture condition, temperature and numerous other factors. Compostable organic material normally contain a large number and many different types of bacteria, fungi, molds, other living organisms. Methane produced by bacterial decomposition of organic matter. Methane is a major byproduct of decomposition of plant material in swamps, oceans, rice fields and animals and especially from cattle. Such bacterial methane can pass directly into atmosphere. Globally, agricultural sector is the primary source of methane emission to atmosphere. Although many types of organisms are required for decomposition of different material, the necessary variety is usually present in material to be degraded. An organism thrive when environmental conditions are satisfactory. During decomposition, marked changes take place in nature. An abundance of biological population, temperature and change in available food supply exert the greatest influence in determining the species of organism comprising the population at any time. Aerobic composition is a dynamic process in which the work is done by the combined activity of succession of mixed bacteria, fungi and other biological population. Chemical decomposers include bacteria, fungi, actinomycetes, and physical decomposers that include mites, millipedes, centipedes, snails and slugs. Requirement for efficient decomposition. Decomposition of organic matter in compost pile depends on maintaining microbial activity. Efficient decomposition occurs if aeration, moisture, particle size and sufficient source of carbon nitrogen are in evidence. Aeration, oxygen is required for microbes to decompose organic waste. Some decomposition occurs in the absence of oxygen, however, process is slow and foul odors may develop. Because of the odor problem, composting without oxygen is not recommended in residential setting unless the process is conducted in full closed system. The more oxygen, up to at least 10 to 12%, the more quickly the biodegradation will take place. Moisture. Adequate moisture is essential for microbial activity. A dry compost will not decompose efficiently. Proper moisture encourages the growth of microorganisms that break down the organic matter into humus. Avoid overwatering. Excess water can lead to anaerobic conditions which slow down the degradation process. Particle size. Grinding the organic material before composting greatly reduces decomposition time. The smaller the size of the organic refuse particle, the more quickly it can be consumed by microbes. A shredder is useful for chipping or shredding most landscape refuse and is essential if brush or sticks are to be composed. Temperature of the compost pile is very important to biological activity taking place. The microbes that make up the bulk of decomposition process fall into two categories. Mesophilic, those that live and function in temperature of 50 to 113 Fahrenheit, and thermophilic, those that live at temperature between 113 to 158 Fahrenheit. A well-mixed working compost pile will heat to temperature between 110 degree Fahrenheit and 160 degree Fahrenheit. As the microbes feed on organic material at this temperature, these high temperature will help destroy weed seeds and disease organisms within the pile. Organic matter in aquaculture pond. Aquatic organic matter can be further divided into two components: dissolved organic matter, measured as colored dissolved organic matter or dissolved organic carbon. Particulate organic matter, they are typically differentiated by that which can pass through 0.545 micrometer filter, while particulate organic matter cannot pass through 0.45 micrometer filter. Aquaculture ponds are limited to maintain a sediment pH above 7. There usually is plenty of dissolved oxygen in water column and the organic matter entering ponds tend to easily decomposable. Around 90% of organic matter entering a pond during a crop cycle normally is decomposed by the end of crop cycle. Part of the remainder is discharged in effluent when the pond is drained, but a small portion remains in the sediment. When ponds are dried out between crops, most of the remaining fresh organic matter is decomposed. However, through sediment was not removed, organic carbon concentration 25 to 50 years old pond was still only 2 to 3%. Organic matter accumulates in aquaculture ponds because the depth of sediments in deeper parts of the ponds accumulates usually at an average rate of about 1 centimeter per year. Accumulated organic matter usually doesn't cause problem in ponds over time. During a given crop, the decomposition of fresh organic matter imposes a sizable oxygen demand. There is a limit to the amount of organic matter that can be added to ponds without causing problems. With low dissolved oxygen concentration during the crop, either at sediment water interface or in the water column, mechanical aeration is necessary to increase the rate that added organic matter decomposes during crop. Applying limiting materials to the pond with acidic waters and bottom soils can help manage organic matter and water quality issues. Organic matter decomposition in water column. Decomposition of organic matter in water column. As decomposition of organic matter occurs in water column, but much of particulate organic matter settles to the bottom of the pond. Decomposition is rapid in layer of flocculent fresh organic matter that accumulates at the sediment water interface. Of course, part of this organic matter mixes with underlying sediment, is covered with new sediment before decomposing. In the water column and surface layer of sediment, there are usually several milligrams per liter of dissolved oxygen, aerobic condition, but at the depth of few milliliter into sediment, microbial activity depletes molecular oxygen as anaerobic condition raises. Aerobic decomposition converts organic compounds to carbon dioxide and water, but many of these microorganisms that can decompose organic matter anaerobically do not completely convert organic compounds to carbon dioxide and water, resulting in a large amount of organic remains than present where decomposition is aerobic. There are other anaerobic bacteria that can use these decomposed organic residue and break them down to carbon dioxide and water. The decomposition is favored by the presence of dissolved oxygen. Decomposition rate, the simplest way is to use first order kinetic equation. Ds over dt is equal to minus ks, where k is the constant dependent or environmental factor. When organic matter decomposes, its components do not decompose at the same rate. Proteins, fats and simple carbohydrate compounds faster than fibrous components such as cellulose, lignins, tannins and waxes. The majority of an organic residue will decompose within a few weeks or months, but some of the material will persist for years. Moreover, the microorganisms of decay excrete organic compounds, and when they die, they become organic matter. The excretion of organic microorganisms and resistant remains of decomposing organic matter form large complex molecules of humic substances known as humus. In terrestrial soil, organic matter analogous to humus also accumulates in the sediment of aquaculture ponds. These materials decompose very slowly as compared to fresh organic matter that deposits on the bottom during aquaculture crops. Soil ecosystem can be defined as interdependent life support system composed of air, water, minerals, organic matter, macro in microorganism, all of which function together. The organism and their interaction enhance many soil ecosystem functions and make up the soil food web. The energy needed for all food web is generated by primary producer, the plant, photosynthetic bacteria, algae, that uses sunlight to transform carbon dioxide from atmosphere into carbohydrate. Most other organisms depend on the primary producer for their energy and nutrients. They are called consumers. Consumers decompose organic matter towards humus, retain nitrogen and other nutrients, protect roots from disease and parasites, make retained nutrients available to plants, produce hormones that help plants grow, and retain water. Soil life plays a major role in many natural processes that determine nutrient and water availability for agricultural productivity. Soil organisms support plant health as they decompose organic matter, cycle nutrients, enhance soil structure, and control population of soil organisms. The living part of soil organic matter include a variety of microorganisms such as bacteria, virus, fungi, protozoa, algae. It also includes plant roots, insects, earthworms, and larger animals such as mice, rabbits that spend part of their life in the soil. The living portion represent about 5% of the total soil organic matter. Microorganisms, earthworms, and insects help break down crop residue and manure by ingesting them and mixing them with minerals in the soil, and in the process recycling energy and plant nutrients. When plant residue are returned to soil, various organic compounds undergo decomposition. Decomposition is a biological process that includes the physical breakdown and biochemical transformation of complex organic molecules of dead materials into simpler organic and inorganic molecules. As in this cycle, continual addition of decaying plant residues to soil surface contributes to biological activity and carbon cycling process in the soil. Carbon cycling is continuous transformation of organic and inorganic carbon compounds by plants in microorganisms and macroorganisms between the soil, plant and atmosphere. As decomposition of organic matter is largely a biological process that occurs naturally, in decomposition process, different products are released. Carbon dioxide, energy, water, plant nutrients, these are released and resynthesized organic carbon compounds. The successive decomposition of dead material and modified organic matter result in the formation of more complex organic matter called humus. This process of conversion into humus is known as humification. Humus affects soil properties as it slowly decomposes. It is resistant to decomposition. It contributes nitrogen and phosphorus and other nutrients, and increases soil aggregation and aggregate stability. After conversion into humus, now the next is immobilization. Immobilization, where the nutrients are converted from inorganic to organic form, taken by soil microbes and incorporated into the soil, making them unavailable to plants. Now the next is, after this immobilization, the mineralization process. Mineralization is the opposite of immobilization. Mineralization increases the bioavailability of nutrients that were in decomposing organic compounds. Mineralization is decomposition that is oxidation of chemical compounds in organic matter. Whether the decomposition of an organic compound will result in mineralization or immobilization is dependent on its concentration as stresses of carbon in the organic matter. Soil organisms, including microorganisms, use soil organic matter as food. As breakdown the organic matter, any excess nutrients are released into the soil as in the form of mineralization. These nutrients are used by plants. This release process overall known as mineralization. The waste products produced by microorganisms are soil organic matter. This waste material is less decomposable than original plant and animal material, but it can be used by a large number of organisms. How human actions impact the carbon cycle? Humans have changed the natural balance of the carbon cycle. How they change the natural balance of carbon cycle? By the use of coal, oil and natural gas to supply our energy demand. Fossil fuels are a sink for carbon dioxide when they form, but they are source of for carbon dioxide when they are burned. The equation for the combustion of propane, which is simple hydrocarbon, shown here. Propane reaction with oxygen, conversion into carbon dioxide and water. This equation shows that when propane burns, it uses oxygen and produces carbon dioxide and water. So when a car burns a tank of gas, the amount of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere increases just a little. This results in increase in atmospheric carbon dioxide. The second largest source of atmospheric carbon dioxide is deforestation. Trees naturally absorb carbon dioxide while they are alive. Trees that are cut down lost their ability to absorb carbon dioxide. If the tree is burned or decomposes, it becomes a source of carbon dioxide. Coal, oil, natural gas, as well as calcium carbonate, rocks, ocean sediments are long-term carbon sinks for natural cycling of carbon. When humans extract and use these resources, combustion makes them into carbon sources. The priming effect is characterized by intense changes in natural process of soil organic matter. The phenomena is characterized by either pulsed or continuous changes to input of fresh organic matter. The priming effect results in acceleration of mineralization. Due to it, triggers such as fresh organic matter input. The cause of this increase in decomposition has been attributed to an increase in microbial activity resulting from higher energy and nutrient availability released from the fresh organic matter. After the input of fresh organic matter, specialized microorganisms are believed to grow quickly and only decompose this newly added organic matter. Other soil treatments besides organic matter inputs which lead to this short-term change include input of mineral fertilizer, more mechanical treatment of soil or its drying and re-wetting. Priming effect can be either positive or negative depending on the reaction of soil with added substance. A positive priming effect results in the acceleration of mineralization, while negative priming effect result in immobilization. As both of these have been already discussed, leading to nitrogen unavailability. Although most changes have been documented in carbon and nitrogen pools, the priming effect can also be found in phosphorus and sulfur as well as other nutrients. Lohinus was first to discover this effect in 1926 through his studies of green manure decomposition and its effect on legume plants in soil. He noticed that when adding fresh organic residues to soil, it resulted in intensified mineralization by the humus nitrogen. The priming effect can arise either instantaneously or very shortly after the addition of substrate, or the priming effect is larger in soil that are rich in carbon nitrogen as compared to those poor in these nutrients. The size of the priming effect increases as the amount of added treatment to the soil increases. Real priming effect have not been observed in sterile environment. When microbes die, they decompose, releasing ammonium and tiny particulate containing particulate organic nitrogen and dissolved inorganic nitrogen into seawater. Some microbes convert ammonium to nitrite and nitrite to nitrate. Because nitrogen transformation include both the formation and decomposition of organic matter, much of the nitrogen used in photosynthesis is locally recycled back to ammonium or nitrate to support another pass through the cycle. The net removal of nitrogen in particulate, dissolved or gaseous form can cause cycle to slow down or even terminate unless new nitrogen is imported from an external source. New nitrogen is imported from surrounding regions, for example nitrate injections from below or locally created ammonium organic nitrogen from nitrogen fixation. Regenerated nitrogen is locally recycled ammonium from ammonification, nitrite from nitrification, and dissolved inorganic nitrogen from grazing or cell lysis. In shallow coastal regions, runoff from land or movement upward from sediments are potentially major source of ammonium nitrate and dissolved inorganic nitrogen for water column processes. However, in most open ocean environments, new sources of nitrogen required to balance the net losses from euphotic zone are restricted to upward diffusion or mixing of nitrate from deep water and to local fixation of nitrogen gas. In a balanced steady state, importation rate of new sources of bioavailable nitrogen will concentrate the export of nitrogen, including fisheries production and harvesting. Nitrogen cycle. The ocean absorbs nitrogen gas from the atmosphere. In open ocean areas with low concentration of nutrients as oligotrophic regions, some of the nitrogen is taken up by microbes and transformed into various chemical compounds. The key steps in the process are mentioned here. In the first step, nitrogen gas from the atmosphere dissolves into seawater at the ocean surface. Nitrogen gas is the most abundant form of nitrogen in the ocean. Dissolved nitrogen gas is taken up by just few microbes, which convert nitrogen into a much usable form known as ammonium. This process is known as nitrogen fixation. It's very important process. Ammonium is the form of nitrogen that is most easily consumed by microorganisms. For this reason, ammonium is consumed almost as fast as it is produced. This process is called assimilation, in which ammonium consumption takes place. The result is that nitrogen becomes incorporated into the cells of living organisms. Some marine microbes consume nitrite and nitrate, another form of assimilation, because conversion of ammonium to nitrite and then nitrite to nitrate takes place. by some microbes. When microbes die, they decompose, releasing ammonium in tiny particles containing particulate organic nitrogen, which is known as PON, as well as dissolved organic nitrogen into surrounding seawater. Some microbes convert ammonium to nitrate, as shown here, and then nitrite to nitrate. Thus, two-step process: first step, ammonium to nitrite conversion, and then nitrite to nitrate conversion, is known as nitrification. The result of this process is that nitrate is released into ocean. A host of organisms consume particulate organic nitrogen and dissolved organic nitrogen. Some of the nitrogen back to ammonium. This process is remineralization. To complete the complex cycle, some microbes convert nitrate and nitrite back to nitrogen gas through a process denitrification. The open ocean is host to a wide variety of microbes, each adapted to perform one or more steps in nitrogen cycle. However, reduced nitrogen compounds such as ammonium are easy for most microbes to use than oxidized nitrogen compounds such as nitrate. Many types of microbes extract energy from nitrogen compounds by oxidizing these compounds, for example, converting ammonium to nitrite or nitrite to nitrate. A few microbes reduce nitrogen, for example, converting nitrogen gas to ammonium, because this requires extra energy which they must get from other source, food or sunlight.